Okay, so thank you to the organizers. I'm Jean-François Vercher. I'm a professor at Essier Paris, which is an engineering school in the east of Paris. I'm a bit annoyed because I have asked for a full talk on. Actually, I don't really know how much time I will speak. 20 minutes? No, normally it was 40, but perhaps will it be 20? Okay. So the second thing, I'm a bit in trouble, but not a big trouble, is that in fact it's not in the objective is not on Python, it's not on data, it's on Jupyter. And Jupyter, like we saw in the talk of Sylvain Corlet. And what I'm going to show is how to develop extensions for the Jupyter notebook. And I will also present some particular extension. So there are two objectives. Present and describe some Jupyter extension by myself and by others of the group, which is indicated here, the Jupyter Contribution in B extensions group, which is an informal group where some extensions are collected, improved, and so on. So these extensions, we will see them. They are useful for improving, for adding functionalities to the notebook development, code development, to do authoring, that is to prepare documents for publication, and for classroom animation by adding some functionalities useful for the classroom. Several speakers here said that it was interesting to participate, to open source, and so on. And actually, the Jupyter NB extension group is also a forum for experimenting, giving new ideas, and learn and have fun, and so on. Okay, so. A last point is that I call for new ideas and contributors for this group. So a small tiny extension here is the fact that we can mask some cells just to see if I forgot something. Yes, I forgot to say that I will preferentially describe extension of I've contributed two, but also some other one. And even if I say I or my or so on, often there are many other contributions in the source code. The source code can come from over source, and the code can include suggestions, patches, and so on. Okay, so we had a wonderful introduction by Sylvain Corlet on the Jupyter notebook. He also said that we must be involved in open source, and he says also by asking the people that in fact almost everybody has already used the Jupyter notebook here, so I don't need to advocate much. Just a small recall on what is the Jupyter notebook. Formerly, it began as the IPython notebook, and it was just tailored for using Python and building a notebook around Python. And then after, it has been extended to enable many kernels. So it's a browser application. So as you see, it works in the browser, and you can use it as an IDE with integrated documentation capabilities. You can do reproducible research, and you can implement demos and full experimentation for teaching, especially using using IP widgets. Okay, so in these different areas, all the basic capabilities of the notebook can be extended through a notebook extension, which are extensions written in JavaScript, and on which have access to the ever the functionality of the browser on the API of Jupyter. Okay, just I recall here that the notebook essentially has two types of cells. Just for the people who may don't know, you have markdown cells, okay, which contains this kind of code. The first line is a level 2 section. You can mix links here. Have a list and also include equations and so on. Okay. You can also have code cells, which contains standard Python cells in this example, Python code in this example, but maybe some other language. So I can run this. You can plot and embed plots in the notebook itself. Okay, so that's the basic functionalities of the notebook. Okay, you can mix both commands, perhaps a lecture in education, or commands of your research on your research development, and then you can have code. Also image, perhaps videos, and so on. Okay, so the point is that all the basic capabilities of the notebook can be extended through through notebook extensions. And these notebook extensions can modify the user interface or the behavior, or add buttons to the toolbar, add keyboard shortcuts, and of course you can also invent, design new functionalities. Okay, so I will begin by an example of a small toy extension. And I will show you what is the basic structure of a Jupyter notebook extension. So the basic is that in order to write a new extension, you must implement the logic that your logic in a JavaScript file that will be executed by the browser with a JavaScript file that conforms to that as that is a module, an AMD module. That can be loaded by Jupyter using require.js, and your module must export a specific function with the name load IPython extension. Once this is done, the extension is ready and can be loaded, and the code in the load IPython extension will be executed and can execute itself, function that you define elsewhere in the module. Okay, and so within that your script, you can manipulate all the aspects of the browser, that is of the DOM of the object model of the page. You can invoke Jupyter JavaScript API. You can listen for specific events. You can load over modules and so on. Okay, so. Let us just look at the way to design an extension. So what I propose here is to add a menu button on a keyboard shortcut And when you press on the keyboard shortcut, it will display a keyboard an alert dialogue. First, I must. Okay, just later. Okay, so the source has the following form. This is the definition of the AMD module. Okay, so it says that you have a big function that imports, require, exports on module from the JavaScript interface. And then in your AMD module, you will define, here it is, you define a load notebook extension, and in fact, you will export this load notebook extension under the name load IPython extension. So in the Jupyter, when it loads the whole extension, it will execute the function with the name load IPython extension, which in fact is this one. Okay? And in this extension, what I do is first add a button. Okay? Let's add a toolbar button and add a keyboard shortcut. Okay? So this does only two things: add a button, add a keyboard shortcut, and when you press the button, the function with the name main function, or when you do your keyboard shortcut, the function which is called is also the main function. So you can put in the main function here, what I put in the main function is an alert box. Okay? Okay. So if we try to execute this, Control Enter. You see that we have a new button here that has appeared, and if we press the button, we have the dialogue that appears. Okay, the alert dialogue that appears. Okay, so just with a small piece of code, you can do this thing. Of course, it doesn't serve to anything, but now what you have to do is to put something interesting in place of the main function, right? Okay. Okay. We can organize the code. That is in the code. What I do here is that I define an initialization function, a function that show the toolbar, show the button. Just I mention here that in fact the Jupyter function here is to add a series of buttons. Here I just had one, but you can add several buttons in only one instruction. Similarly, you can define several shortcuts. Okay, so the rest of the structure is the same. Simply, I say here that you can organize your code. In the third evolution of the same extension, I add here something not really useful, but I add some code to transform the extension that I defined into an extension that changed the case of the selected text. Okay, so just look at the new code. Here I have added a JavaScript code that changed the case of a string, okay, that transformed the upper letter and lower letter and vice versa. I had a function that here that get the selected text. That is, if you select some text in the notebook, okay, you can catch it through this function. And then if you have some selected text, you pass it to the toggle case function to change the case. Okay, there are some more logic here which says that if you have not selected anything, I change the case of the text of the whole cell. Right? Okay. Okay. And finally, the last. I will reload the page first. Where is it? Okay, finally, two other steps, and I will show the demo of the final extension. Finally, you can think to load a specific configuration. Here, in the different parameter of the extension, I have put in hard the name of the icon which is displayed for the button, and I have put in hard the keyboard shortcut. Of course, user may want to change the keyboard shortcut or to change the icon for the button and so on. Actually, you can store. Where is it? You can store configuration, or you can read configuration in the system, in the configuration file of the notebook. There's a file whose name is notebook.json, where you can store information. You can also store information in the notebook itself, and you can read this information. So the idea here is to have a step that reads a configuration and read the correct parameter in the configuration. So what we usually do is to have a configuration in three steps. First, you have a hard-coded configuration in the extension. Second, you have a configuration within the system. And third, you have a configuration at the notebook level. So if you have no configuration in the system, you put the hard-coded one. If you have no configuration, if you have configuration in the system, you take it. And if you have a configuration at the notebook level, you take it. This enables the fact that we store configuration in the notebook itself enables to store the states of the extension for each notebook. I will give some example later. But you see what I want to show is that you can read the configuration in the system here. You can read the configuration. Sorry, you can put your configuration here, you can update it from the system, and maybe you can update here from the notebook metadata. Okay, and finally, a last point to mention is that sometimes when you load the notebook, For large notebook, it may take some time. Perhaps it may take a very long time. And sometimes the extension that you use needs the notebook to be fully loaded or needs to have the kernel available. Okay. For example, we will see the table of contents extension. The table of contents extension needs to have the notebook fully loaded in order to read all the headers in the notebook. So you can't run the extension before a specific event. So that's done here. That's done here. You wait for the notebook to be fully loaded. But no, you test if the notebook is fully loaded. If it's loaded, you do your work. That is, you initialize your extension. And if it's not loaded, you wait for the event that is sent when the notebook is loaded. So this structure, which is important, enables to synchronize in some way and wait for everything to be available. So if we came back to the extension, so let's run it. Sorry. Ctrl H. Okay, here you see the toolbar available, and with this instruction, I load the last extension I show you. Okay, the button has appeared here, and then we can select, this. Okay, press the button, and the case is changed. You can select it again, press the button, you can select nothing, press the button, and everything in the cell is changed. So it doesn't serve too many interesting things, but don't know, perhaps people can be interested in that, but you see that you can, with the very same approach, put the text in bold, in italic, on whatever you want. You may add a toolbar button for like in text processing for changing the case, changing the font face, and so on. Okay. So just as a little summary, what we have seen in this very small extension. I don't show it really, but what you have seen is that you must have a main JavaScript file. Okay, which has an EMD, which is an AMD module. This JavaScript file can load some other JavaScript modules. Maybe your main JavaScript file can itself load some CSS. Okay, some CSS in order to style to style your result. And sorry, one thing that I didn't mention, here. In fact, when I said that we can specify parameters, I forgot to mention that Josh Barnes, this contributor of the IPython notebook extension group, has written a NB extension configurator application, which looks like that. Okay. It lists all the available extensions in your system, and for any of the extension, the one we have developed is here. For any of the extension, it lists all the parameters that you have defined in your extension so that you can change this parameter by some user interface. Okay, you can, if the parameter is a string, you can edit the string. If the parameter is a keyboard shortcut, you can edit the keyboard shortcut, and so on. And the result is stored in the notebook system. Okay? So and that's the configuration that you can load afterward. And how it works, in fact, you can define, you can define the list, your list of parameters using this structure. You list your parameters, the name of the parameter that you will load afterward from the system configuration, its type. You can specify an icon. You can specify a README file, which will be displayed when you ask for the help for the given extension. Okay. I will make a small tour. I had 40 minutes. Yeah. So finally, I'm not so short. More interesting. No, I will do a tour of some of the available notebook extension. There are many available on the web. many available on the Jupyter Notebook Extension Group, but there are some other and some other very interesting floating elsewhere. So for each one, I will try to point out the history, the kind of functionalities that have been added, give some hints, some idea of the implementations of the implementation ideas that have been added when by this particular extension. So I begin with some extension that can be used for classroom, that I use for classroom. The first one is the extension, how the extension exercise on exercise 2. Exercise was an extension by Jürgen Asch. On exercise 2 is a fork by myself, but the underlying logic is quite the same. So let's look at a small demo. And let's look at a small demo here. Okay, I have a text. This comes from a lecture I give. I have a text, I present an algorithm, and I say to the student to implement some line, and then to test their implementation using the following code. And now in the very same document, I can give the solution, which is mask by default, and show it. Okay? And show it. And the way to define it is as follows. You select the cells. Okay. Then you press on the button here. This takes the first cell as a heading cell, and the other one as the cell to be masked and shown when you want. Okay? And this is saved in the notebook. That is the state of the toggle button on and off is stored in the notebook. That is, it is stored in the cell metadata. Each cell enables to store some information, and in the cell itself, you can say that there is a solution. Okay, there is a solution, and that this solution is either not. And when you reload the notebook, the extension being loaded itself, it loops over all the cells and masks the ones that are marked to be hidden, and show the other one. Right? So that's an example of implementation. Okay, I don't go too much into the code, but just I point that I spoke of the loop over all the cells to restore the last state that we have before quitting the notebook, and I just mentioned that you in order to get the cell. You have a command which is a Jupyter or a Python notebook get cell, okay? Then you get a cell object, and in this cell object, you can put information into the metadata, okay? You have a metadata field where you can put all the information you want, and you can read back this information and do things with that. Okay. A second extension that I use for class is the highlighter extension. So I will just present the demo. Okay, you have a button here. You have a button here that you can put I show you. And when you press into one of the button, you get the selected text and highlight this selected text. If nothing is selected, we highlight the whole cell. So this is useful for students. You distribute them Jupyter notebook. Okay, everybody has the notebook Jupyter, and then they can highlight with the color they want the part they feel important. How it works? It works like I presented before. You get the selected text, and then what is done is to put an HTML span with a style color, okay, with a color style. And this color style can be defined in the extension parameters. Okay. An important point here. Where is it? An important point here is that, of course, you are modifying your notebook, but you want to preserve this. Okay, the information is stored in the notebook, but you may want to export the result to HTML, to LaTeX, to Markdown, and so on. So this is possible. There's an utility which is called NBConvert that converts the notebook to many formats, and the NBConvert also enables to use pre and post processor. A preprocessor is some code that is executed before the conversion, and a post processor is executed after. So you can develop a small script, which is this time a Python script. You can develop a small script that takes care of preserving the information you want. Because the information that I had in the notebook is not waited for by NBConvert, so you have to transform it or to put it in form before. So just a look to the preprocessor file. The preprocessor, okay, it's a Python file. Actually, it's a class, okay? It's a class, and what you have to do in the class, in fact, is just to subclass the function preprocess cell. The function preprocess cell resave the cell one by one before the conversion, okay? Before the conversion, and then in the cell, what I do here, I look. If the export is LaTeX or HTML, and if the export is HTML, in fact, I replace the cell source by some transformation and put it after as the new cell source. Okay, the specific problem here is that we added HTML in the Markdown, and that this HTML is in the Markdown might be converted by NBConvert to show as HTML and not with the given colors. Right. Okay. Another nice extension is an extension by Mobile, which adds a snippet menu. That is, the extension adds a menu here. Snippets that enables to include snippets of codes. So this can be very practical to have some snippets of code that are stored on by the menu. You can directly. Let's have a look if we can snippets. Where is it? Okay. Doing that, I enable the extension. Now I can load this file. Okay. Now we have a snippet menu here. And the snippet menu presents all this. Let's add a cell. I had a cell. I go in the snippet menu and say I had. Sorry. Python. Okay. I had some code that I've been stored before. Actually, if you look at the configuration of this extension, you can select what you want to appear in the snippet menu. You can also go and edit what is in the code and so on. Okay, let's turn to 14. Let's turn rapidly to usability. In the usability, I want to point out to the table of content 2 extension. This extension is a fork of the talk extension. I made simply a small demo. Sorry. Okay. This extension add a button here. This button display a sidebar with all the headers in your notebook. That is the extension when it loads. Looks at all, collect all the headers in the notebook, and then build a list and display this list. This list, of course, can be clicked. That is, you can go where you want in your notebook. It also add. It's not here, but we have an option that display a navigation menu here. On the capabilities. It enables to number or not the different section, okay? And eventually, if you click here, it adds a cell at the beginning of the notebook with the content of the table of contents. This sidebar can be moved, okay? So you can put wherever you want. You can reduce it. Okay, and you can put it as a sidebar. Okay, where I am. Okay, another useful extension is the Python Markdown. The Python Markdown, actually it works not only for Python, but for any kernel. This extension enables to Okay, this extension enable to execute some code. It doesn't work. Well, perhaps that it is not. Where is it? Python Markdown. Mm-hmm. That's the problem of the demo. First, my click doesn't work. Okay. Okay. Sorry. Okay, for some reason, I don't know, it doesn't work. Normally, it will insert in the cell the content of the variable. Okay, another extension is the LaTeX of, where is it? The LaTeX of extension. The idea is that is to get the text that is in a Markdown cell and unable to use standard LaTeX in it. For example, you can use. Let's see it. No. Okay. For example, you can input code like this. You can input code like this. You can define a theorem with a label. Put your theorem, include an equation, and so on. And you will have your code in the Markdown cell interpreted like this. And of course, the colors and so on can be defined. We have the extra option that the theorems, the structure that you employ, can be automatically numbered. Okay, so you can number. If we had here, no, it's not a good one. Plus. Okay, I'm just make a small demo. So you have things automatically interpreted and on number red, and of course you can reference to the label that you indicate here. Say one, then here I put ref to one. Okay, and so this is valuable. This is valid for the whole notebook. Okay, I'm late. Just I point another funny extension, the NB translate. This extension enables to translate a given cell into another language. Into another language, it works like this. You push on the button here, and it's not the good one. Okay, and it translates it in French. Sorry, I have a lot of problems. Yeah. Okay. Here, in this toolbar, you can select the destination language. For example, if I'm here and say that I want to translate in what you want, Bosnian. Okay. Here it is. Here it is. Everything is automatically renumbered and so on. The translation is simply a call to the Google Translate engine. It translates, puts a metadata in the cells that enables to choose the language that you want to display. So you can have a notebook with many languages inside, a multi-language notebook. With this extension, using the NB convert facilities, you can specify which language you want to export. That is, you can have a multi-language notebook that you have developed, and you can transform it into several notebooks, one for each language that is inside the first one. Okay, I just want to take 5 minutes on say something on the extension for code developments. We have developed an extension called CodePrettify. This extension CodePrettify, okay, let's look at an example. What it does, it takes the content of a cell, and when you press the button, it takes this content, send it to the Python kernel, in this case, and this Python kernel execute the yet another Python formatter module that returns the text with the correct structure. Okay, so here the idea is that you can take the content of the cell, send it to another program which is executed by the current kernel, on which return the text, the transformed text that you put in back into the cell. It also works for hair, okay, with the same structure. That's right. Wait, okay, or for JavaScript, and so on. And in fact, the architecture is such that you can add all the kernel you want. The structure is get the text, call the current Python kernel, transform the text, and put it back. Okay. With the same ID, we have built a 2-3 extension that converts a Python 2 code, like here, into a Python 3 code. Okay, you see that the print has changed, and if you look at the instruction here you have URL lib2. Okay, and when we do the conversion, the converter will change the instruction into the Python 3 instruction. Okay. No, it's not here. And I will end with a variable inspector. A variable inspector is an extension. Where is it? Okay, I show it with the demo here. The variable is inspector actually call the kernel, Python, R, JavaScript, whatever you want, and execute a script that can be specified by the user, that can be edited by the user, that looks at the variable that are in the namespace. Okay? So here we found a possible implementation in IPy widget that was transformed here into the form of a variable inspector, and it works like this. Okay, you have your variable inspector, which lists all the variables that are in your notebook. Okay, and you see that if I define a new variable, it appears in the list, and you can even delete variables from the variable inspector. You have the size and so on. Okay. Among the missing thing, if you want to build a package, actually you can embed the notebook extension into a Python package and install it via pipe. So these are two examples. The last thing is that I will put this document shortly into my GitHub account. Thank you.